If your engine is burning oil and is always smoking at the back, here are two things you should do before concluding that your engine is worn. A friend of mine recently sold his car for peanuts because his car was smoking heavily, and the worst part of it was that he didn't do any of these checks. He probably joined the many people who think that their engine is worn and go ahead to do a tear down or sell the car for next to nothing. But join me for two quick things that you can do at home. Now let's get this. One thing you shouldn't do immediately when trying to determine whether your engine is worn is doing a compression test. More on the reason for this in a bit. The first thing you should do if your car is burning oil and is smoking is to clean or change the PCV valve. A positive crankcase ventilation valve that is clogged and stuck in the open position is going to vent so much oil vapor from the crankcase through the breather tube into the intake manifold that your car will either smoke or burn significant quantities of oil. Just for context, this is the amount of oil in my catch can collected from a good PCV valve over a 5,000 mile period. If you're able to get this quantity of oil from a good PCV valve that opens and closes at intervals, just imagine what the quantity would be if the valve is stuck open. PCV valves are inexpensive and should be cleaned or changed somewhere between 20 to 50,000 miles. However, if you've changed your PCV valve and the car still smokes, dump a good fuel system cleaner into the tank, take the car to the racetrack and drive it at high RPM. And by this I mean some real wide open throttle driving. The reason why you want to do this is that extensive idling or slow city driving encourages build up in the combustion chamber, and these deposits also collect in the piston ring grooves, which over time can cause both the compression and oil control rings to get stuck in these grooves. When this happens, excessive oil from the sump is going to make its way into the combustion chamber. These deposits will also clog the oil drain back holes on the piston. The high heat generated from this intense driving usually burns off the deposits and frees up both the compression and oil control rings. And so stuck or sticky oil control rings is the reason why I said you shouldn't rush into doing a compression test if you think your engine is worn, because if these rings are stuck in the piston, you're going to get subpar compression results. I used to burn this amount of oil on the dipstick in about 1,200 miles, but following my use of Liqui Moly valve clean on several high RPM runs, this is the amount of oil loss after 2,500 miles. You would agree with me that this is a big difference. At this point, just to say that if you have mechanical noise from the engine or you're having timing related codes, you definitely want to fix those before engaging in wide open throttle driving, just to ensure you don't damage your engine. If you're worried about speed limits, a viewer here suggested that he was able to get his oil control rings free by driving in low gear at high RPM for about 2 to 3 miles. I haven't used this method myself, but something you may want to consider. As a last resort, some have also done piston soaks, which I haven't done, but definitely one of the things I'll consider before giving up on my engine. If any of these have worked for you, please give me a shout in the comments. Hope this has been helpful. Do like, share, subscribe, and turn on notifications if it has, and I'll catch you on the next one. Peace!